Hey, I appreciate that. Thanks. Yeah, it was quite a shock. I mean, we didn't even know Dad had heart problems. Well, they're saying natural causes, but I want to check out a few things while I'm out here. I tell you what, though, you ought to see this place. I mean, there's stuff everywhere. It's like he didn't take care of anything once Mom died. I mean, there's an arrowhead collection. There is so much stuff, this is going to take forever. Yeah. Well, hey, man, I'd love to see you, too. Hey, we'll talk about Bosnia. Strictly on the down low, that's right. Well, at ease, Staff Sergeant. We'll catch you later. All right, thanks for calling, bud. Yep.
Oh, hey, Jim.
Zeke.
Long time no see.
Yeah, man, sure enough. You doing all right?
Doing good, thanks.
Good, man, good. Sorry about your dad, man.
Thank you.
He was a good dude.
He was,
man. If you need anything, give me a holler.
Will right? Do.
All right, man.
All see and I. Zeke, you haven't changed a bit.
You know me, man.
Good to see you.
See you, buddy.
Hey, Major Pal. It's good to see you again.
Hey, you too. Man, store manager now, huh?
Yeah, bringing in the big bucks.
I hear you. Place looks great, though.
Thanks. Hey, I'm sorry to hear about your dad. I'm going to really miss seeing him in here.
Yeah, I appreciate that. Tell me something. Did he show any signs of a heart problem?
No. He always seemed as healthy as a horse. Actually, I was surprised to hear he died of a heart attack.
Yeah, me too.
Hey, he had an order come in today. It's already paid for. Do you want it?
Yeah, might as well.
All right, give me a second.
So no warning signs, huh?
No. He was actually really excited to get this order. Talked about some sort of adventure.
Why would Dad order all this camping gear? You order stuff like this often?
No. Just a couple odds and ends here and there, but...
Well, hey, I appreciate it.
Of course. It's good to see you again.
Yeah, you too. See you.
Hey, Jim.
Hey.
Sorry to hear about your daddy.
Hey, I appreciate that. Thank you. Good to see you, yeah. Excuse me, can you pass me that silver thermos? Don't I know you? No, I know I know you. We used to have a class together, that's it. You know, I know I'm right. I mean, I could have sworn we had chemistry. That didn't go so well.
Yeah, you gotta stay away from that one. But chemistry was my favorite subject.
Yeah, I'm sure it was. Probably had lots of lab partners. Anyway, thanks.
No problem.
I know this kind of thing happened around here.
Excuse me?
Raven County woman still missing. Sheriff's Department still searching Petal Creek area where she was last seen.
Used to not, but it's been happening more and more.
Strange. Anyway, thanks.
I get off in an hour. I can walk you home and protect you.
You have a nice day.
You too.
Don't. Where are you going, Dad? Hunting? Camping trip? Okay. Instant mashed potatoes. Go, Dad. What's going on, Dad? Indians and some kind of map.
worse.
Oh.
I know. Mm-hmm. I'm sorry I wasn't here. Dad knew we loved him.
Yeah. I know. Gosh, I mean, I just miss him so much.
Yeah, I do too. What Dad used to say, though, you never know how strong you are.
Until being strong is the only choice you have.
That's it.
You're right. Oh, sorry. It's okay. This is Janie.
Hi.
She's a friend.
Hey, Janie, Jim.
Nice to meet you. I'm so sorry to hear about your dad.
Yeah. Y'all come on in. So, you and Deb been friends long?
A couple months now.
Yeah.
We met Deb.
We were fighting. Mm.
Fighting?
Yeah.
Who won?
We both did.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah. There was this guy.
Yeah.
He was trash.
Mm-hmm.
So what happened?
We realized we weren't.
No.
Okay.
Yes, that's what happened.
Yeah.
Hmm. What's with all this? Are you going off the grid?
It's all Dad's. You have any idea why you order all that stuff?
No, I don't have a clue.
And his heart attack?
Yeah. I don't know. He had been so distant.
Distant?
Yeah, like short-tempered. When Mom died, he really changed. Short fuse. You know, for Dad, even shorter than usual. I don't know. He was acting so weird.
Like how?
Just going on and on about, like, Native Americans and their culture and burial grounds and folklore. I don't know. I guess it was just something he was into.
Alrighty then. Well, anyway, thanks for being such a good friend to Squirt here.
Oh, of course. I just love her. And Squirt, huh? So were you a little kid? Or...
Yeah, that's exactly right.
Let's just say it was more of a nighttime problem.
Oh.
Shut up.
Really, Jimmy?
Well, I guess I've done my official duty as big brother in embarrassing my sis.
Okay.
I gotta head out.
That's fine, because Janie and I are gonna go now, and I'm gonna tell her every embarrassing story of Major Jimmy in the history of Everdom.
Oh, great.
Well, it was nice to meet you.
Likewise.
And don't worry, whatever she tells me, my lips are sealed.
Good afternoon, sir. How you doing? You're Mr. Grady, right? I'm Jim Powell.
I know who you are.
Mind if I drag up a chair? So, Mr. Grady, I think you knew my father.
We're gonna miss him around here.
Yeah, I think a lot of people will. So listen, I was kind of hoping you might help me with something. I was been over to my dad's house and going through his stuff, and seems to have had a lot of interesting hobbies. You know anything about that? Did Dad hang around here a lot? Okay, I'll take that as a no. He was kind of a homebody.
Listen, boy, somebody that goes looking for trouble never misses.
What do you mean?
I mean, have more sense than your daddy did. Pay your respects and leave what needs leaving alone.
Okay. Was Dad in some kind of trouble?
Gerald was messing with some things that just ought not be.
Nothing I saw. Did find one odd thing. It's kind of a piece of paper with a hand-drawn arrowhead on it. Letters ORO. Does that mean anything to you? It's like a...
Don't ever say that out loud around here. Ever.
I don't understand.
gold arrowhead. A mountain, an arrowhead, and gold. A mountain shaped like an arrowhead that has gold in it. A golden arrowhead stuck inside of a mountain? No, that's not it. Gold. Just not making any sense. Jim Powell. Hello? Hello?
Playing all kinds of heart, soul, and rock and roll right here on Lake 97.7.
Question for you. You know of any path or trail that starts out around mile marker 1 on 180, right off of 76 there?
No. If there is one, I've never noticed.
Okay. Yeah, I was just out there. Dad had it marked on a map I found. It's probably nothing. Just wanted to check it out.
We made a lot of trips out into the woods, but I figured he was just hunting or fishing.
Well, did you ever see him bring anything in that he shot or caught?
No. Honestly, I never even knew when he went. He just got to the point that he wasn't talking to anybody much. He did meet up with Terry here and there.
Terry?
Yep, Terry Gort. I'd call and he'd be like, "Can't talk, I'm with Terry." But I don't think you'd know him.
No, I don't. But I'm about to introduce myself. You know where he lives? I don't think so. I'm looking for a man named Terry.
You know of a guy named Terry?
Nope, never heard of him.
There you go. What do you need this guy for anyways? He owe you money?
Nah, nothing like that. My sister said he was friends with my dad. Thought I'd come by and say thanks.
Who's your dad?
Was. Unfortunately, he passed away recently.
Recently. Gerald?
That's right, Gerald Powell. You said that...
I know what I said. I'm Terry. Apologies for all the foolery. People come up in here unannounced. We usually shoot them. We're a careful sort.
Yeah, I can see that. Y'all had trouble?
Well, youngins, they come up in here, steal everything you got. I guess you look the type. What can I do for you?
Well, Dad, he had interests that were quite frankly strange.
Meaning what?
Meaning Native Americans, arrowheads.
Cheryl had a lot of ideas. Fixations on tribes.
I was just hoping that since you all spent time together, you could tell me if he was in ill health or had any heart problems.
Well, not go poking around in things Cheryl was involved in. But this for your loss, you know the way out.
Okay. One more thing. Y'all do any hunting around here?
Sure, we're up in the area all the time.
You ever find yourself around mile marker one on 180?
No.
That's what I thought. Y'all have a nice day. Service from the Towns County area?
Towns County and Union, what can I help you with?
Yeah, are there any trails that lead off Highway 180 going south around mile marker 1?
Not that I recall, but let me look. Let's see. I don't see anything there, but there is an Appalachian trailhead about 3 miles south of you on 76 going towards Helen. May I ask why, sir?
Yeah, I was just wondering. Have a great day, thanks.
That's it. I'm done. You gotta be kidding me. A kid's drawing with an unnamed trail marked with a red crayon. I'm out. I had more intel when we looked for Bin Laden. This is ridiculous. I could be here for weeks. Even if I did find something, it's probably Dad's stash of fishing lures and beef jerky. Stupid. Although, there's nothing to it. Then why is everybody acting so tight-lipped? Why are they asking me to mind my own business? I've been out to mile marker one. There's nothing there. Even if that trail was there, go out to the middle of nowhere. Why the camping gear? Why the camping gear, Dad? Well, just gonna have to find out.
Look. Well, if it isn't the golden arm of Towns County.
If it isn't the slowest running back in the history of Towns County.
It's good to see you, Jim.
Glenn, great to see you.
I heard you're back in town.
Yeah, just back here for a few days taking care of Dad's arrangements.
Yeah, I heard about your dad, and I'm sorry, man. He was a great guy.
He was. I appreciate that. Listen, come on in. I'll get you something to eat. Got some cereal or something.
I can't stay around. I've got to go head out to Lander's farm. I got a fence issue, so I can't stick around.
Look at you, Sheriff. Remember back in the day when you and I used to run from the law? Now you are the law.
Yeah, we don't talk too much about those days anymore around here.
Yeah, I guess not.
So, Jim, Terry Court, what were you doing over at his place the other day? What are you talking to Terry about?
Well, Sheriff, did this visit just go from cordial to an interrogation?
Jim, I'm just doing my job.
Mm-hmm. Well, Deb said that Dad and Terry are pretty good friends, so I went over there to ask him a few questions.
Such as?
Hey, look, if you got a question to ask, just ask it.
Nah, I'm good. I'm just checking on you. Mm-hmm. Listen, when you leave, look me up, and you're going to be leaving when?
I'll be home by Sunday.
Sunday, good. It's good seeing you, Jim.
Mm-hmm.
Take care.
Hey, Cosmopolitan, please.
Coming right up.
Hi, baby. Can I get a beer? Another one? Well, hey, little lady.
Hi.
You look like you need some company.
Back off, pal. She's with me.
Thanks for that.
No problem. Although I'd hate it if you can't mark off your bucket list getting picked up at a bar.
Did Deb tell you that's my number one?
Hey, wait, I can do this. Let's see.
Thank you.
How about, excuse me, miss, can you step away from the bar? You're melting the ice.
Oh, I see. Well, how about this? Well, here I am. What are your next two wishes?
What's a smart, attractive man like me doing without your number?
Sounds like somebody loves himself.
Mom always said there'd never be anybody good enough for me.
So are you not wearing a ring because you're hiding it? Or is that legit?
There's no tan line here.
True.
Yeah, I was married once. Mm-hmm. But as they say, the grass is always greener. She ran off with our attorney about 8 years ago.
Sorry.
Mm-mm. Yeah, don't be. Yeah, he's already moved on to a newer model.
Wow.
And I hear that she's back living with her parents.
Oh. Deborah told me you might be here.
Really?
Yeah.
And how would she know that?
She cloned your phone. She knows wherever you go. I'm just joking. I saw your car when I drove by. How you doing?
It's all so confusing.
Deb filled me in.
Yeah. Something's off.
What do you mean?
I mean, Dad died. Got these hillbillies coming out and telling me to mind my own business. Dad's got these mysterious maps and drawings. And the sheriff comes by my house today.
What did you do?
Nothing. Sorry.
That's okay.
It'd all be different if people weren't acting so weird.
It's been like that for a while. Everyone's on edge. Ever since that woman went missing in Rabin.
Yeah. Well, thanks for talking with me. Been alone for a while.
Of course. You know, there's only one thing left to say.
Really, what's that?
Does your left eye hurt? Because you've been looking right all day.
How about this one? Hey! Are you two gonna kiss? Back off, pal.
Oh my God.
I'll have another. He won't.
I surrender.
Rangers never surrender. I taught you that the first day, son.
Sir, yes, sir.
Little cherry berry. I do believe you wet yourself that first night.
You kicked my butt, that's for sure.
You tell anyone about that, I'll kill you. I expect to see you around here.
I came here to warn you. I just hear you've been asking questions.
What, if some kind of small town law passed when I wasn't here that says you can't ask questions?
From what you've been talking about, yes.
You mean I want to get arrested for asking questions about my father and how he died?
This place has changed. People go missing and nobody asks questions. Nobody.
You mean like that Raven County woman?
Exactly.
When did this all start happening?
I'm not sure. But what I do know is that people whisper, but they never talk.
Well, last I heard, you were involved in some wet work. You still active?
Oh, no. Buried my last one outside Atlanta 3 years ago. I work in my uncle's barbershop now.
Still using blades. Nice.
Yes, sir. But now they're just for shaving. It's not really the people up here. Well, some of them have turned. It's really the people who don't belong here.
I'd like to see someone keep me from talking while I'm holding my loudspeaker.
Yeah, they've got loudspeakers too. And they don't like you asking questions.
How do you know so much? You one of those townspeople that's turned?
Nah, man. When you're a barber, you hear all kinds of things. You know more about this town than the mayor. Or his wife.
Well, thanks for the heads up.
Yeah, well, keep your head down, Major. Some of these boomerangs can take it off.
Well, what they're forgetting is this. I'm a loudspeaker. Trip to take.
Just like the birds in flight, the stars up in the sky, just like the sun and moon, just like the flowers bloom. So just
he's at the portico. Yes, ma'am. I go get the boys.
I was right. He knew something. Find it.
creation flows like open waters. We're chasing headlines down like fool's gold. We're quick to speak, slow to learn, and never wonder if all the lines were sold or as proposed. 'Cause we placed our trust in its intervals, somewhere in between you and the other side. There's a truth that we deny. It's fighting for our lives. Oh, this black and white, this bipolar state of mind, it's eating us alive. Yeah.
Hey, buddy. Where are you going? Where are you headed off to, huh? Well, it's a nice day to go hiking or hunting, but by the looks of you, I say you're hunting something. Tell me, what are you hunting, huh? You know, pigs in season right now.
Just doing some research.
Oh, research. Boys, we got your professor here. Weren't you looking for something like a bird? Yeah, maybe we can help you out with that. What do you think?
I don't need any help. Thank you, though. I'll be on my way.
I wasn't done talking to you. Yeah. Easy there, big fella. Easy. You pointing the danger sense of that long palm at me. All right, I don't want any trouble. Just a bit curious is all, okay?
I think our conversation's done here.
All right.
You have a nice day. Yeah.
Yeah, this is Hawk. Yeah, I got him. He's at 34 degrees, 51, 11.9 north by 83 degrees, 44, 54.7 west. You got that?
Another clue leads to more questions. At least you left me a snack, Dad.
Thank you.
come here often? Whoa. You would ever tell you you're kind of scary? Guess you have a tough time with the guys, huh?
Oh no. Whatever will I do? My life has no meaning.
Whoa! She speaks!
I hope that hurt.
Don't worry, it does.
You don't belong here.
Yeah, so they tell me. I think everyone's cleared out, so I'm gonna head out too.
You're injured.
Yeah, well, I tried to do a cartwheel and didn't work out so well. You're a tough nut to crack. Hey, if you're making dinner over there, I'm allergic to shellfish.
This is for your injuries. You can eat it. It's not made from shellfish.
What's it made out of?
My grandmother taught it to me. It's been passed down through our tribe for generations. And it'll stay in our tribe.
Okay. Just trying to make conversation. Well, I tried. Or is that a secret too?
Cherokee. I'm half Cherokee. My mother's full blood.
Not so bad. Kind of smells like that stuff Doc used to put on me when I was in, never mind.
No, continue. That was the first interesting thing you said.
Sorry, can't. That secret has to stay with my tribe.
Oh yeah? What tribe are you with?
Major Jim Powell. 75th Ranger Regiment, at your service.
Wonderful. U.S. military.
Well, I'm not here on official business, ma'am. My father, he just passed away.
Sorry to hear that.
Yeah, thanks. And, thanks for that.
Powell. I knew a Powell. Gerald Powell.
Yeah, that was my dad. Do you know him?
He sought after me, wanted to know about the area, Cherokee lore and legends.
ORO?
Yes, Major Powell. ORO. Gold. White man's greed. Whatever you want to call it, still the same thing.
Can you tell me everything you told him?
In 1838, President Jackson sent troops and militia to forcibly remove the Cherokee and other tribes from their homeland. My great-great-grandparents lived in that land before the Great Spirit breathed life. They were forced from their homes to walk thousands of miles, having to bury their family along the way in shallow graves because the ground was too frozen. And the soldiers said it took too long to bury them.
Trail of tears. Not America's finest moment in history.
One of many.
ORO?
Right. The gold. You know, 3,000 of us died on that trail. All for some—
Sorry. I didn't mean to interrupt. Please continue. Please.
So you know about the Trail of Tears? Did you know that the Cherokee found gold in Dahlonega 10 years earlier?
Really? My dad. He used to take my sister and I down to Dahlonega, pan for gold. Never knew the Cherokee found it.
Yes. My great-great-grandfather was one of the tribesmen that found it. Knowing white man's desire for gold, he and the other tribesmen started mining it and hid it. And then word got out, and people started to swarm the area for their fortunes.
Anybody ever find the gold that your great-great-grandfather hid?
No, because President Jackson passed the Indian Removal Act, and the leaders got together and decided to hide it to never be found.
So do you know where it is? Is that a family secret that's passed on for generations?
You hear about thousands of people forcibly removed from their rightful homeland, and it's like, oh, that's such a sad story. I'm sorry to hear about that. Then you hear about a gold mine, and it's like, oh, hey, yeah, show me the money.
No. I just want to find out what happened to my dad.
I could tell you what happened to him. He was murdered.
What? How?
He wasn't the only one looking for it.
With what I'm paying you, I expect results, not excuses. If I wanted excuses, I'd still be married to my second husband. How hard can it be to find one man? He took all of Gerald's research. You find him, or you won't be found. Oh! That idiot is the reason we had to get rid of Gerald. That old man knew too much. Go back to the compound. If Gord heard something, I want to know what it is.
Yes, Miss Fade.
Hey, Sable. You don't look happy. Again.
I'm surrounded by idiots.
Talk to them.
I refuse to have a battle of wits with unarmed men.
Well, talk to me.
We've got a problem.
I thought we got rid of the problem.
No, not him. His son. He came for the funeral and he's been poking around.
How much does he know?
I'm not totally sure. We almost had him the other day, but then he disappeared.
I could have Danya there in 2 days. She can find him.
No, not yet. I think we've been going about this all wrong. We've been getting rid of the competition. Maybe we just need to get out of their way.
I think you're taking a big chance.
Well, when and if he finds anything, we can just take it from him.
True. If anything goes sideways, let me know.
I will.
So who is this Sable Fade, and why did he kill my dad?
She.
You think I care about pronouns? Why did it kill my dad?
That's closer to the truth. She's not human. She killed my uncle, and anyone else would take up the search to find what my ancestors left.
Does she have people looking?
Always. They're all around town, threatening families, trying to squeeze information out of people. And she bought off the land and businesses, trying to corrupt the politicians. She'll do anything and everything.
That explains why people were treating me so weird. I still understand why Dad would take up something so dangerous and not tell me about it. I could have helped him.
Protection, probably. The woman is pure evil, and she'll stop at nothing to get what she wants.
Sounds like she has enough money already.
It's about the power, not the gold.
Right. Wait, what? What power? Gola.
Got it.
Got who?
Breakfast. How do you like your squirrel?
I don't. I prefer beef or deer.
You ever had squirrel?
My dad and I used to go camping all the time. And when we did, we'd always hunt. I learned a lot. But I never had to eat squirrel. Let me guess though.
Please don't say chicken, please.
Tastes like chicken.
So predictable.
Really? Did you know I was gonna do that?
Well.
You lied. Tastes like chicken. You were saying.
What?
Before you went all squirrel hunter on me, you were saying something about power.
I asked grandmother. Elise, if there's so much gold, why hasn't anyone ever found it?
Right, exactly what I was thinking.
Elise told me the tribe shaman traveled to the Great Tennessee River to perform a ritual.
Tennessee River, how would that help?
The Cherokee view the Tennessee River as a kind and helpful spirit. His head rests in the Great Smokies and his feet touch the Tennessee River.
So the shaman went to this Tennessee River spirit to get some help?
An immortal.
Right, immortal, okay. You know, like a vampire.
Really?
I'm sorry.
Look, go ahead, immortal.
They're a group of spirits known as the Immortals. They're invisible unless they want to be seen. They drum and they dance and...
Now, wouldn't we hear all this drumming and dancing?
You do. And the rumbling of the mountains and the sounds of the wind.
Hmm. Well, did this great Tennessee River Immortal help the shaman out?
He did. He asked him for an object. The only thing he had was an arrowhead that he wore around his neck. It was passed down through generations. The great spirit held up the arrowhead and he prayed, "May every path that you travel be a wide field. May every secret kept from you be revealed. May the winter of your years never be sealed."
Wow. It's beautiful.
It's beautiful. But it's also dangerous. The arrowhead turned to gold and the shaman headed back home. Along the way, the trees and rocks moved out of his way and the hills parted for him to pass. After a few more steps, he realized that old age no longer kept him from running and he felt young again and he ran all the way home.
So the wide fields allowed him to pass through anything and the silliness of his age made him young again?
But that's not the worst part of it. When he returned back to the village, everyone came out, but not to greet him. To tell him about every deed they'd ever done.
Every secret shall be revealed. What do you do?
He hid the arrowhead in the gold, vowing to never use it again.
Wow. You believe?
I believe Sable Fade believes. I believe anyone who possesses it would be unstoppable. And I believe my grandmother.
What are you going to do?
I know she's looking for it, and I want to find it before she does. If the wisest of our tribe thought it was too powerful for him, and grandmother thought he was the best of us all, it's the least I could do to protect the world from someone like Sable Fade.
Well, I agree. I'm with you. You know, I don't know if my dad knew about this arrowhead or not, or if he was just in it for the gold. But I'm not about to sit back and let some witch that killed my dad get away with it.
I've watched you in the woods. You're pretty good.
Well, I'm good with guns. Good with knives.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow. That's impressive. I am so glad you were here to protect me from the big scary tree. Easy. Easy, easy. See? She just wanted a little breakfast.
Most important meal of the day. Just glad we're not on the menu.
It's time to go. It does taste like chicken.
How do they know the path?
By accident. They don't know exactly where they are.
Well, with four-wheelers, they're gonna get here fast.
Let's grab our stuff. I have an idea.
Any way to greet a friend?
You ain't a friend. Boy, don't you know what happens when people drive up in here?
I ain't just anybody, Terry. You know it.
What do you want, Van?
You know why I'm here. Sable wants to know if there's been any new rumblings around town.
Why's Sable asking me that?
You know why.
Well, I know that Gerald ain't around anymore. I do know that. And I know his boy's in town asking a lot of questions. That's all I know.
You sure about that, Terry?
I'm sure Sable wouldn't take too kindly to her best ear to the ground being split ear to ear.
All right, boys. We're good here.
Now, we're good.
You better be right. For both our sakes, we'll be dead.
Ruby ain't got the guts to send Donnie up in here to see me.
Ever go four-wheeling and shooting at the same time?
Yeah, in a video game. I didn't know this was gonna be part of our day.
It might be.
This should be it.
I told you, I've been through here many times and nothing.
Hey. What does this one mean?
Those are carvings of animals that hunters would do as they were resting and waiting to pass through.
What kind of animal leaves wavy line tracks?
Why is this here?
What?
ARA. It's the Cherokee word for water.
Was it ARA or ORO?
Yes. It's water.
I don't want her here.
She scares you?
You said not to send her.
Well, things have changed.
So you want him dead?
Well, not yet.
Then what do you want?
I want her here just in case. It's my checks she cashes. If I want her here to clean the litter box, then she'll be on the next plane. I don't explain myself to you.
I'll get her on it.
He was in this area.
Was?
Our boys have found his trail. Make it easier to follow him and to get to where he's going.
Well, that's good, because I'd hate to have to put you on Danya's list when she gets here.
You really need her here. She makes everyone uncomfortable.
Oh, she makes you uncomfortable?
Ma'am, she's associated with at least four open homicides.
That's because she's a professional. I'm beginning to think she's the only one.
I really think we could...
Any more suggestions?
No, ma'am.
We have a long history of successful transactions. I'm sure I can keep her under control.
She'll be invisible?
Yes, she will.
Thirsty?
Water.
What you been saying?
I just knew that I used to swim here as a kid. I knew this place.
So what do we do now? Dive in?
Kind of wishing you were native still now, Major. Yeah.
Thank you.
know this place.
Hey, you okay? A little weak.
I remember this place.
Okay. And there's enough excitement for one day. Let's head on back.
But I know this place.
Hey, look. I know a place, too. Some food, hot shower. Come on. We can come back tomorrow.
What we have here. Hey, not so fast. How about you take that piece out slowly with two fingers and toss it to the ground, huh? That's it. Oh, you won, buddy.
Yeah. Well, I see you got four of you here to try to fulfill that fantasy. How about you let your girls go here and give it a shot?
How about you shut up and show us the map? Well.
All right. They're right here in my pocket.
Hey! Slowly!
It's right here.
Give me the map. Your second. This is a forestry map!
Go on. It's coming to help. This guy's not gonna know the ice in his head or his...
Let's go.
You're shot.
You're driving.
Hey, you feeling better?
Much.
Oh. Let's take a look at that wound. Hey, is that it?
Thanks. I think I can manage.
Okay. Well, anyway, I think I found that waterfall and field we were in. I can see why nobody knows anything about it. Unless you knew exactly where to look, you'd never find it.
I told you I knew that place.
Yeah, you did. And that's about all you said. Look, I'm sorry. I'm just confused, irritated, tired. I didn't mean to take that out on you. Look, you said you knew something about this field.
Yeah, but I haven't been there in over... I haven't been there in a while. My uncle used to take me there when I was little.
This is the uncle that Sable Faye killed?
Yes. He used to take me to the falls, and we would swim. And he would tell me these great stories about battles and great spirits and ancient spells. And then we would go behind the falls to the fields, and past the fields were these whispering rocks.
Whispering rocks?
It was the coolest place. My uncle would have me stand on one end, and then he would go all the way to the other end, and then he would whisper these silly things that would just make me laugh, and I could hear it just all the way from over there.
It's amazing. You think we can find that place tomorrow?
Yeah, I remember it now. My uncle would say, "Be careful, Ustigola. Remember, there are no secrets in the rocks."
Usti? What is it, like your first name or something?
No, it means little. Little Gola. Hmm.
Well, your uncle's right. Shouldn't have any secrets. Maybe we should try that.
All right, no secrets. No secrets. No secrets.
What's the matter, Hawk? Can't you be a man? Take care of some little girl and pound you into the ground.
She wasn't alone!
Your men are supposed to be trained. They're supposed to be able to take care of some little girl and some old soldier. What's the matter, Hawk? Can't you talk? Well, how about we play a little show and tell? Did she hit you? Did she kick you?
Actually, it's the other way around.
Shut it!
Well, isn't this sweet? If this isn't the stupid, leading the stupid.
Danya.
Vent.
Can't say it's real good to see you.
That's the thing, can't. You wouldn't ever see me. You'll just be walking along, being an idiot, and then, boom. Have you address for me?
By the way, orders have changed. She wants him dead. I'd be careful. He's combat trained.
I am not planning on getting closer than 900 yards.
It's all making sense now. The secret rocks, the white rocks, I mean, everything that my uncle said.
Go on. Slow down, slow down. Take a breath. Now, your uncle.
My uncle took me when I was young to all those places. The fields, the white rocks, the secret rocks.
The white rocks? Are we talking rocks that are painted white?
Oh, Jim.
Or rocks that are actually white?
The fields, the white rocks, the secret rocks.
Okay.
Do you remember the blessing from the Long Man?
The Long Man?
Yeah. Tennessee River, immortal.
The shaman. He visited him, he gave him an arrowhead.
Right, right. And the blessing went, may every path you travel be a wide field. May every secret kept from you be revealed. May the winters of your years never be sealed.
Go on. You did it. That's it. The blessing. It not only describes that the power of the arrowhead is the map itself. That's it.
Yeah, that's it, Jim. And now you can go and get the gold.
I don't care about the gold. The gold doesn't belong to me. All I care about is getting that arrowhead before Sable Fade. That gold, it belongs to the Cherokee Nation, not me.
Thank you. Thank you for thinking of my people.
Of course, yeah, and your people. I just wish your uncle could have been around to see you find it.
And your father.
Yeah.
No, they liked each other so much. And they used to pick on me a little bit, actually.
Wait a minute. You told me you barely knew my father.
I know, I did, Jim.
What is it, Gola? I mean, now I'm sitting here finding out that not only did you know my father, your uncle did too.
I'm sorry. Sorry, Jim, but when I met you, I didn't know who you were.
Yeah, well, what did you think when you found out who I was?
Okay, all right, just calm down, Jim. Sable Fade has been after anybody who was helping your father and my uncle from the moment that they started searching. And then when she murdered them, I got so scared and I hid up in the mountains and I was so alone and I was alone for a long time. It was just me and Agi Dutsi.
I'm sorry. I just don't do surprises well. Look, we're both tired. Let's just go get some rest. Good night, Ustigola. Listen, I'm sorry about last night. You were right not to trust me. You didn't know me.
I do now. Jim.
That's a 308. We've got to get out of here. I want to find something for this guy to shoot at. Hang on. Here. Listen, when you hear the shot,
You get in the house as fast as you can, you get everything we need, and get out of here. We're not coming back. Are you ready? All right. Go!
Fine. Who was that?
Had to be Sable. Sent a sniper. Small town, broad daylight. She's desperate.
We need to find that arrowhead. Now, more than ever.
We know exactly where to look.
Just get it for me. I don't care how much it cost. Just get it. Are we scared of doing something illegal?
Not that illegal.
That's why the check's so big. If you do a good job, I'll double it.
How do you know I'm trustworthy?
Because if you weren't, you'd be dead.
It's just that the entire area that you want is county land. In fact, I think it may be protected by the Cherokee.
I'm sorry, but did I just hear you say the word think? Because it is already well known that that is not your mouth, it's mine. And it will say whatever I want it to. Now, say yes, Mrs. Fade. I'll take care of it.
Yes, Mrs. Fade. I'll take care of it.
Good. You're excused.
Danya's here.
Oh, finally some good news. Dear Danya. So now do we have two dead Powells?
I was unable to confirm.
Ha! I told you she'd miss.
Vant! Go now and find her. I want to know what she knows.
Who?
You know who. Go find her and tell her I want to talk to her. And as for you...
Zabiyo Barba.
English!
I will kill a bot. I will find him, I will take him and his little girlfriend down. No charge, 2-for-1 deal.
Girlfriend? Sister?
No, they're definitely not related.
What does she look like?
She has dark hair, dark Cherokee, and she doesn't look so pretty. You know her?
No, but I knew her uncle. Briefly.
We're almost there. Just a few more miles ahead.
Should we? Hey, that's the truck from the other day.
We can't lead him to the waterfalls.
Let's see if he drives as bad as he fights. Hang on. Lost him.
So what do we do now?
Well, Dad's house is compromised, so that's not an option. And Deb's house... Deb, I gotta call her.
Listen, she's not involved with this right now. Remember, your dad kept this from you to protect you. Maybe that's the best thing for her now, too.
Okay. Well, it's quite a hike up to that waterfall. Even if we could double time it, we'd make easy pickings for a sniper. We need something 4-wheel drive.
Like what?
And we need reinforcements.
Listen, we can't get anyone else involved with this.
Cherry Berry? Yep. Yeah, grab your kid. It's time.
Cherry Berry? Jim, this isn't a...
I need you to trust me, okay? I've got a lead on something to get us up to the waterfall. I want to drive you into town. I need you to check on my sister. You don't have to talk to her. I just need you to see if she's okay. Get eyes on her and call me.
Okay. I trust you, Jim.
want to see me? He's got a girl with him now. She goes by the name Gola. Her uncle was the one we removed with Deborah's father, Gerald. Deborah has been more than helpful with information. I'll continue being her friend until, as long as possible, I guess. I've also been able to make a possible compromising relationship with her brother, Jim. I think next time I see him, I can seal the deal. Have I done something wrong? I've done everything you've asked. Would you just tell me what you're thinking? I'll do it. Just tell me.
I'm thinking, why do I still need you? Did you know I swam competitively as a child? I did. My father was very hard on me. I could never do anything right. My form, pathetic. My strokes, embarrassing. My speed, lethargic. One day, our friends were all gathered around and we were celebrating because after a meet, I had taken first. First place. And with all my friends around, my dad came up to me and grabbed my sides in his fist and said, "You've got to cut the fat, Sable. It's slowing you down." "I need to cut the fat, Janie. You're slowing me down."
"Sable, hold on. Just wait a minute. I'm very valuable to you. Just let me prove it. Just tell me what you need. I'll do it."
"I need Jim Powell."
"Whose is this?"
"It's mine."
"Then why are we hiding?"
"Because this guy stole it from me several years ago."
"Why didn't you just take it back?"
"Because I stole his girlfriend, and then he stole that." "Trust me, he got the better deal." "Right, shh. Listen, I need that RTV. And I need to know he's still not sore about that old swab. He used to work nights, so chances are he's not here right now."
I don't see a car here, so I think we're good."
"All right, good. Let's move stealthy. Come on."
"Now identify yourself."
"Jim Powell, Hank."
"Jim Powell? Well, last time I saw you, you was a little bit whiter."
"That's my partner. Put the weapon down. I got something to talk to you about."
"Well, I will as soon as I can lay eyes on you."
"All right." "Hey, Hank. It's been a while."
"Yeah, it has been a while."
"Hank the Tank!"
"Yeah, the golden boy, the golden arm."
"You know
it. The golden smile."
"That's it."
"I heard you were dead, man."
"Not yet."
"What is going to happen if you keep sneaking to people's backyards at night?"
I hear you.
"Hey, I'm Barry."
"Hey, Barry. Sorry about earlier."
"It's okay."
"Hey, Hank, listen. I need to borrow the RTV."
"It's mine. I won it fair and square, remember?"
"You and I both know you did not win that fair and square."
"But it's still mine."
I hear you. "But listen. I don't want to keep it. I just want to borrow it for a couple days. I'll bring it back. It's just for a special project of mine."
"I don't even want to know why, do I?"
"Probably not."
Well, there's no tag on it, so you don't have to worry about getting traced.
Okay, cool. Well, hey, thanks, Hank. Talk to you soon.
All right. Hey, Barry, find some better friends to hang out with, okay?
Shut up, Hank.
I mean, we've looked everywhere for Jim. Where do you think he'd be?
I don't know. Right by the cabin?
What cabin?
Pick up. Hi, Jim.
Hello?
Jim, I need you to come get me now.
Hey, you okay? Is Deb okay? Did y'all get in some kind of trouble?
Nothing I can't handle. All right, how far out are you?
Okay, we're just around the corner. We'll be there in just a second.
Okay. All right.
Hey, it's Gola. She's up way around the corner. Let's go that way.
Okay.
Oh! Hey, you seen Deb?
She's with some... Barry? Cherry Barry, this is your reinforcement? He's the barber.
Hey, Gola. Looks like it might be time for you to come see me.
Hey, Gola, get in the back. We gotta get out of here.
So your dad and your uncle were killed. Then you were chased. Then you got into a fight.
And don't forget and then, the wolf.
Right, the wolf. And the chicken squirrel, there was a sniper, a car chase. I almost got shot by some yahoo with a 12 gauge.
And don't forget, I was attacked earlier today.
Why are we not leaving?
Because I'm not gonna let some old, mean, crusty woman get her way.
Really?
Shut up.
That's what you
can
got.
Do better?
No, a soul-sucking, pantsuit-wearing, frosty-tip, manipulative defiler of all things good and holy?
She did not get those frosty tips from me. Seriously, though, I am a little concerned about my uncle. If it's all right with you, Major, I'd like to go on over to his place to tell him to keep his head down for a couple days. Maybe get him to stay with his cousin in Silva.
Yeah, man. I'm sorry.
It's fine. No, I think we're doing a good thing. It's dangerous, but good.
No, Barry, I'm sorry about earlier today. I really appreciated your help.
Yeah.
Honestly, if it wasn't for you and Jim, I would have no one to trust. And ever since my uncle was killed...
Never shall I fail a comrade. Right, Major?
Who lost Staff Sergeant? You okay?
I'm getting there. Jim... I am.
It's okay. We can take it slow. We've been through so much and I...
It's not that. It is that, but it's so much more than that. Look, there's so much about me you don't know, and I want to be completely honest with you.
You can tell me anything. I mean... You're the most amazing woman I've ever met.
I feel the same way. So, here it goes. Okay, my uncle and I...
Shh. Did you tell someone we were here?
Who am I gonna tell? Maybe Barry's coming back?
No. He didn't know how to announce himself.
Give me a heart attack.
Come on in, come on in.
We were so worried. Janie insisted on coming to help me look.
I'm just glad to see you're okay. Hello over there.
Sorry, are we interrupting?
No, this is Gola. Gola is my sister Deb.
Nice to meet you.
And Janie, I've been busy.
I can see that.
That's not what it looks like. Her uncle was good friends with Dad. Deb. So Gola and I, we've been kind of looking at some things that her uncle and Dad were into.
Like what? Do tell, please.
Well, at the moment, there's not a lot to talk about, but for now, we kind of got to keep things on the down low, so the less people know, the better.
Don't worry. Your secret is totally safe with us.
Yeah, I don't like the sound of that, Jim.
Some things are better left unsaid, and Jim will explain it to you later.
Be careful. I'll see you tomorrow.
Well, tomorrow we got a few things to finish up, so...
No. I'll see you tomorrow. Yeah?
She's been kind of worrying a lot these past few days.
I know exactly how she is. Just like my mom, she's a worrier. But you need to help me out and remind her that I'm never going to dig a hole deeper than I can crawl out of.
Well, do you need somebody in the trenches with you? I make a really good partner.
No, but thanks for asking. Gola and I are just about finished up.
That's sad. You said you had something you need to finish up tomorrow?
Why do you ask?
I don't know. I just thought we could get together for dinner. Maybe we can do something.
Well, not tomorrow. Maybe some other time.
Okay, fine.
Rain check?
Well, you better hurry. Sugar melts in the rain.
Sure it does.
It was nice to meet you, Gula.
It's Gola.
Right. Bye.
Bye. Sugar melts in the rain? Really? I just could vomit right here. I don't like that woman. What? Shut up. How did he even know about this place?
She didn't. Deborah did. We used to use this place as kind of a party house when we were kids.
I don't like it, Jim.
Like what?
Them knowing where we are. Sable has people everywhere.
Deb is not a Sable Fade secret agent.
Okay, fair enough. But still, don't you think it's dangerous they know where we are?
All right, I agree.
I know it's a hike, but nobody knows about my place.
Well, that'll work. I'll just call Deb and let her know we won't be staying here.
Yeah. Yeah, we're at the location. Yeah, we're about to move in. I remember.
All right. I'll see you tomorrow. Okay, love you, sis. Good night.
It's just a matter of time now before you have possession of Jim Powell. I know I took my time getting close with Deborah, but when you wanted Jim, I gave him to you. I knew when he came in town that I should keep tabs on him, so I cloned his phone.
Shut up, Janie. It's annoying to hear you so pleased with yourself.
Sable, I don't know what I did
to... I don't care what you don't know. I only care about one thing.
The gold.
No, you moron, the arrowhead.
Arrowhead? There are thousands of arrowheads. Farmers find arrowheads.
Can those arrowheads tell the future? Can they tell you privileged or confidential information? Can they stop time?
And do you think an arrowhead like that
is in Towns County?
I don't think it. I know it.
How?
Well, in 1974, Daddy had a breakdown. I loved it. There was no one else I would rather see it happen to. But Mother was concerned. Oh, not for his health, but his wealth. You see, she couldn't possibly drink herself to death in anything but designer shoes. So Mother sent him off to a sweat lodge in Oklahoma, and she said it was, oh, how did she put it? So that he could become one with his inner spirit animal.
What?
Like most addicts, Mother went through a experimental phase. Daddy, well, he became friends with the locals, and he started smoking the peace pipe with them. They would tell him crazy stories about magical and golden arrowheads. They thought, what can this hurt? Some white guy up for the weekend on a romp. Yeah, but they didn't know Daddy. Once he set his mind to something, he didn't let up.
And you really think that story is true? That an arrowhead with all that power would be in this county?
Yes. Idiot. Hello? What? It's time to get personal.
I told you, Sable Fade has people everywhere.
Who, Janie?
Yes, Janie, or whatever her name is. What about Deborah?
With Sable Fade? No way. But it's obvious that she's got Janie staying close to Deb.
And you.
Gotta get her away from Janie before she gets hurt.
What?
Too late.
Jim, I'm so sorry. Wait, there's another text. Deborah is safe for now, but they want the arrowhead. Jim, we can't give Sable Fade the arrowhead. With it, she could...
I know.
It's a location. A barn at the end of Farmington Road? Why? Where is that?
It's on the other side of town. There's nothing around it. It's a perfect place for Sable. There's nobody around for miles.
What are we gonna do? 1 hour.
1 hour. You can't plan anything in 1 hour.
I think that's the whole point. Jim, I don't want Deborah to get hurt, but...
I know what you're gonna say. Just let me say it. Sable Fade cannot get the arrowhead. No matter what.
No matter what. So what are we gonna do?
You go get that arrowhead. And hide it.
And you?
I'm gonna go get my sister.
I need to know where Jim is.
I already told you, I don't know anything. Please let me go.
Okay, Vant, that's enough. Go check on Hawk and his idiots and make sure they're where they need to be. And tell Danya to come in here. So hard to find good help these days. Deborah, dear little sweet naive Deborah. I need to know where Jim is.
I told you. I don't know.
Know where he is? Yes, you said that. I'm getting bored with this. So, here's how it's gonna be. Tell me where he is now, and I'll let him live. If not, you can watch him die.
Die? What is going on here? What does Jim have to do with any of this?
He knows where the arrowhead is.
Arrowhead? This is all about a stupid arrowhead? There's thousands of arrowheads around here.
That's what I said.
Janie, please help me. They've got me tied up. Please. Janie.
Sorry, babe. It's just business. Jim's on his way. Well, Lisa's phone is.
Okay, Vant, go get ready. Jim's on his way. And Danya, pick a spot. Get him in your sights. Don't kill him. I still need him.
And the Indian girl?
I don't need her.
Good.
I didn't like her anyways.
This is Barry the Barber, and I want to cut you. Cut your hair, I mean. Leave your name and number, and I'll call you back. Style you later.
Barry, it's me. I'm in the weeds. I need backup. I'm at the old barn out on Farmington. Bring everything you got. We're going to need it. You okay?
I'm okay.
Are you hurt?
No, I'm okay.
Ah, Jim. So exciting to finally meet a man who's going to give me a present I don't return.
Sorry, I have no idea what you're talking about.
Oh, no? Oh, Janie. Fill him in, Janie. Oh, you do remember Janie, don't you?
Vaguely. Reminds me of a call girl tried to pick me up at a bar.
Honey, please. Like you could afford this?
Yeah. Medical bills would be staggering.
Enough, Jim. Where is the arrowhead?
Arrowhead?
Vant, cut off his sister's hand.
Whoa! I have to have our witty banter here, huh? Okay! Look, I don't know where this arrowhead is. If you give me just a second, maybe we'll work something out.
Interesting. Nah, I'm tired of this, Vant.
Hey! I'm gonna need everyone to stay right where they are.
Jim! They kidnapped me, please!
Is that true, Mrs. Payne?
Guilty as charged.
What are you waiting on, Glenn?
Yes, Glenn, what are you waiting for?
Glenn, no.
I'm sorry, Jim. I'm just in too deep. But the pay sure is good.
You're late.
Sorry, ma'am, police business. But I did bring you a gift. Hey, Hawk!
Come on!
Oh, good.
Do you have it?
No.
Did you find it?
I did. I hid it.
So it's not here?
No.
Good. Then I have a plan.
Okay, now that we've had our little reunion, it's time to get down to business. Now, I don't want to have to threaten you and have Vamp cut you and blah-de-blah-de-blah-de-blah, all that. Anyway, why don't we just all act like adults and someone tell me where my arrowhead is?
I'm kind of tied up at the moment.
Just how I like my men. I'll get it for you, Sable. Last chance, Jimmy. You and I can make the perfect team.
There's no I in team, but there's a you and screw you.
Jimmy, you don't have to be so vulgar.
Oh, honestly, Jenny, get your loins under control and bring me the map! Start talking.
I want to make a promise first.
Oh, really?
Yes, really.
Oh, well, this ought to be fun.
I'm going to kill you for murdering my father.
Oh, Jim. Oh, I thought we decided not to threaten anymore.
What are you going to do, shoot me?
No. No.
Go on!
Okay, any more threats, or are we ready to talk?
We didn't find the arrowhead. But we did find the trail. We're gonna go out there in the morning.
Good, thank you, Jim. So now, show me on the map where it is, and we'll go there tomorrow and look for you. And just to show you that we're a full-service resort, we'll give you an extra night with full access to all our staff until I have the arrowhead in my hand.
It was there.
Sheriff?
Yeah, I know it. I've never been there, but I know it. There's a waterfall and some fields.
All right, take Hawk and the others and go there. Right. Now, get Hawk, it for me.
Let's go.
I can't believe my search is almost over. It's been so long.
You've done a lot of horrible things through the years. All those innocent lives, you're gonna burn for that.
I agree. But the good news is, I'll live long enough to forget what I've done. And you'll live just long enough to see me get it.
Oh, you're gonna get it.
This is for my uncle! Arrowhead is mine.
Stop, Sable. It's over.
Oh, it can't be over. I promised my daddy. And I always keep my promises!
No. But I always keep mine. How? I saw you get shot.
I told you that we had to talk about something.
Yeah, I'd say. You first start with telling me how you're still alive.
Well, I...
Hey, I heard Jimmy. Is everyone okay in here?
Got it all handled, Jerry Berry.
Well then, I got someone in here that wants to say hello.
No puedo creerlo. Debes estar bromeando, Raúl!
The one and only, papi.
What? How?
Berry told me you have mucho problema, so don't be a fool. Call Raúl!
Good to see you.
So I take it you guys know each other?
Oh, yeah. We go way back. I can't tell you how we met.
Or where, or what we were doing, but see,
we know each other.
So I couldn't find out more than legends and stories, but I found out this picture, and I don't know what it means. Are you all right, Papi? You look like you see a ghost.
It's not far from the truth. Thanks, man. Thanks for everything.
Always, brother.
I never did like that picture.
So the shaman
was my uncle. When he removed the arrowhead, it left a drawing tattoo on his chest.
Like yours?
Yes. Once everyone started traveling on the Trail of Tears, my uncle stayed behind. He needed to keep the arrowhead safe. And grandmother wasn't going to leave him, and I wasn't going to leave grandmother. And then she passed away shortly after that.
But that was over 150 years ago.
The arrowhead kept my uncle young. He still aged. In fact, the arrowhead drawing would run low like a fuel gauge. And he would get older, but it was like every year was 7 years. And when he realized it was just him and me, he put the arrowhead on me so that we can age the same.
But my dad?
My uncle really liked your dad. And he was close to telling him the truth, and then they were both killed. My uncle was a private man, and he didn't even tell me about the arrowhead. I guess he left me these little clues along the way so that I can figure it out in case he wasn't here to tell me.
So you surviving that gunshot?
I kind of put the arrowhead on so I could do a recharge. It looks like it's almost back to where it was.
So you're like 200 years old.
Give or take a couple of years.
Wow. Wow. Well, I've always liked older women.
Major, Gula, have you seen this? It's another legend about a Navajo headdress.
And get this. When you put it on, you can time travel.
So I guess we'll have to find it.
I'm in.
Oh, I am not in. I've had enough excitement for one day.
But Major, we need a lot of money for an adventure like that.
I think I can dig up a little inheritance money.
It makes me.